that God, which they had with them, had the power to let them in, but for 40 years had shut them out. And I stopped by because, first of all, it's with carefulness that I wanted to preach this, because I believe that every person sitting here today that's a part of every family can look back over your family tree and find some things that seem to linger in your history. And no matter how you try to plow them out, they seem to follow you year after year. There's some dysfunction in every family. Do I have a witness here? There are some scandals and some things that seem not to be the positive traits of the family. Some families enjoy blessings that other families wrestle with for the entirety of their lives. Israel had now wrestled to become blessed and get to a place that God had designed for them. The Bible says that God designed a land that flowed with milk and honey. That's the way he described it. He said it was a land that he made known as the promised land. But they were not able to get in, and their reasoning for not getting in was that there were some things that existed that was attached to them that did not move the heart of the Savior to be able to allow their entrance. I was blessed when I looked at this because it talked about the fact that 40 years had now come to an end. And it shows that God is a God of timing. That God is a God that sets a time to every event in your life. And there are some things that have been able to keep you sidelined that has a time stamp on it. And when that time comes to an end, God will take what was a mess and make it a blessing. I start out to tell you that this is not for the elect few, but this is for everybody who will believe God. Can you see how this worked? Because they had reproach that was attached to them. There were some things that had happened that stood between them and God, and those things kept them from some blessings. They had wandered in the wilderness. They were going around in a circle. But here this day, the Bible says that God had decided to allow them to move on. They came to a river called Jordan. And I have to pause here because there was two things you got to make note of that happened in the wilderness. And it's the reason for all of our wilderness, because there were some people who got out that couldn't go in. And there were some things that was divested from them while they troubled themselves in the wilderness that prevented them from enjoying the promised land. What I'm saying is that when you're dealing with your wilderness experience, you have to allow some things to die on the inside. Sometimes we stay in the wilderness until God can get rid of some desires. Get rid of some things that we prioritize as kings in our lives. Get rid of some stuff that keep us from glorifying him. Sometimes the wilderness experience is a time where God prepares you for the blessing. And it allows your mind to be reshaped and changed, because with the mind you have right now, you cannot exceed nor endure some things. Neither can you enjoy some blessings, because you've got to get rid of some of the thought process that lives in the family in order to be able to overcome your yesterday. Do I have anybody know that you ought to be the first person to change how your family thinks, to get rid of some of the reproach that linger in the background? You don't have to take the history of the past. The good thing about history is it can change anytime. That your story changes, because history is his story. It doesn't have to be your story. I said history is somebody else's story. Can you look at somebody and tell them it's not my story? If you had somebody that couldn't get over alcohol, that's his story. You had somebody that didn't understand education, that's his story. If you had someone that didn't love Jesus, that's but my story. I'm talking to somebody today and say, I got a different story. And I can stand on the the shoulders of those who came before me and rise to a high level and create a new story so that those who come behind me don't have to contend with the old.
Change it today. Oh, y'all here to tell you, you are special. Man, you are special. You are special.
been healed. But sometimes the sight of the scars. You don't understand. You know, I'm not educated, but you can't deliver up to your education. Because if you talk too proper, your friends are going to go. So you keep talking and not eat right, step buttons.
Around the throne, praise.